Something slightly different today. I just wanted to quickly give some feedback about a particular action cam that I just tried on my X210. Until now, I've been recording with my GoPro Hero 3 White, which is getting on a bit in age. It only does 1080p30, but it's been beaten around, it still works, video quality's okay, and more importantly, the audio quality is also okay. Now, I've tried using it on my X210, but the design of the GoPro 3 with the lens off to one side doesn't really work perfectly with the X210 frame, because you can't use one of the Velcro straps with the cutout, the little carbon cutout that goes around the lens. I did try using just a standard battery strap around the middle of the GoPro, but unsurprisingly that wasn't too secure and it came flying off in the first proper tumble. So I took a look online, I found the SJCAM M10, which is kind of a cube-shaped camera, substantially larger than the GoPro Session and even the Polaroid Cube, but it's 49 quid, does 1080p30, it's still not 60, but it's what I'm used to, I guess, and it comes with a whole bunch of accessories. I paid £49 on Amazon, got two batteries, USB charger, underwater housing, and a whole bunch of different mounts and clips and 3M sticky pads and whatnot, so it seemed like a good idea. And the most inviting feature for me actually was that its lens protrudes out the front, and it's exactly the same dimensions as the GoPro Hero 3 lens. So the little Velcro straps you get for GoPros with the carbon plate that slots over the lens, they fit perfectly around the M10. So I figured I'd try that on my X210. It looks a bit odd, it's a bit top heavy, I guess. Well, not really top heavy because it only weighs about 70 grams, it looks a bit top heavy. But it fits quite nicely with just a normal GoPro strap. It was quite secure through the flights. And, well, the video quality, as you can see, it's not bad. It's got the same sort of oversaturated colours as many of the cheaper action cams seem to have. But the big complaint for me is actually the audio, and I'm going to play you just a quick clip of the audio from the camera, completely raw, unprocessed. I've had it muted till now, I'll just unmute it quickly for you now. And as you can hear, the audio really is pretty garbage. It reminds me of the Xiaomi Yi, the original Xiaomi Yi. If you fly that on even a relatively slow copter, like my tricopter, all you get is wind noise, and this is pretty much just as bad. Now, I know that some people don't like having audio in FPV footage, which is fine. Personally, I quite like being able to hear what the pilot's doing with the throttle, what their throttle control is like, and what they're doing to make a particular move or a particular trick. So I quite like having the audio there in the background. And unfortunately, this just isn't good enough. So luckily, I didn't smash into a tree, so I can return this one to Amazon. I'm going to leave the rest of this flight playing. It's nothing particularly special, but if you're interested in, you know, seeing what the camera's like on a mini quad, then here it is. I apologise for the shaking and oscillations. I just copied and pasted some PIDs from an RC Groups thread, so I think the oscillations, particularly in pitch axis, is just the PIDs rather than the camera itself. In the moments when the quad is sort of free-falling with the throttle down, it seems pretty smooth, so blame me, not the camera, for that.